I welcome you, honourable members, to this session of the NTV People's Parliament, a platform where members can freely speak on issues that affect them and issues of national importance. We are in Chotera, Rakai District, and Agnes Nandutu, the Speaker of the People's Parliament, presides. We would like to thank Deniva for making this broadcast possible and the district leadership for their partnership with the People's Parliament. Madam Speaker, billions of shillings will exchange hands countrywide this year as politicians intensify their campaigns for parliamentary and local council positions ahead of the 2016 general elections. A mini survey by the Observer newspaper last year indicated that individual aspirants plan to spend as much as 800 million shillings to 1 billion shillings. Therefore, I propose that we discuss the topic. Do local people and their issues matter anymore, or is it money, sugar and soap?
I think you have heard for yourself, honourable members. You are welcome to NTV People's Parliament, seated here in Rakai District in Chotera, presided over by none other than me, Agnes Nandutu, the Speaker of People's Parliament. And before we get the ball rolling, I would like to invite the expert to give us the opinion. Yes.
Honourable members of People's Parliament, the Speaker of People's Parliament, first of all, I would like to note that as Deniva, we've been traversing the country and undertaking assessment about the issues of monetization of politics. And through our assessment, we found out that this is a serious problem as we head to 2016 general elections. And among the issues, Madam Speaker, we found out is that due to the prevailing abject poverty in the countryside, people can no longer refuse to receive soap, salt, and money. So the abject poverty is a big and a serious threat to the democratization process. But also, Madam Speaker, what we note is that the private sector and the international community are not absorbed of this problem. They promoted this issue because the private sector always support those candidates. They throw in a lot of money to candidates whom they feel that should be able to meet their political objectives at the end of the day. So, Madam Speaker, these are serious issues we've captured in our engagements as Deniva. And we felt that we need to start debating these issues. So you find that the candidates who would be good leaders are locked out, especially the youth, because they lack the incentives, they lack the money that to give in these political campaigns. And as such, they are locked out. The women who don't control a lot of resources.
Even the disabled.
And the disabled are equally locked out. So we end up getting leaders, leaders who cannot deliver. Most of the leaders who cannot even move a motion on the floor of parliament. But because they have the money, because they have the influence, we end up getting such leaders. And as a country, as an organization, as Deniva, we cannot sit quiet without debating these issues. So we'd want people, we would want to mobilize the masses to vote for issues as opposed to issues of salt, money, and sugar.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Honorable Andrew. What is happening in Rakai, Honorable Chairman, the Chairman of the District? Please, you have the podium.
Thank you very much, Madam Speaker. I'm privileged to be here this morning.
You're welcome.
I welcome the motion. It's not only in Rakai, but all around in our country.
But now we want to know what happens in Rakai.
What is happening in Rakai is almost similar. Lacking something to do by our youth, lacking something to do in our communities, has highly contributed to bribery in elections. So I want to concur with the motion that bribes in elections, buying shop, buying sugar, and giving petty cash is still rampant in our elections. That is why, in most cases, we get leaders who are not capable of serving the people. Reason being that that one who has money will take over the one who doesn't possess money.
But do they deliver, those people who buy themselves into positions?
Sometimes they take time to deliver because they are covering up what they lost in the elections. That's the position in Rakai. Thank you very much, Madam Speaker.
Take the podium, Honorable Member.
I thank you very much, Honorable Speaker of this People's Parliament, Honorable Agnes Nandutu. I'm also privileged to be here this afternoon. I'm called Agnes Namsitwa, Coordinator Kaniva, and a leader in this district.
What position are you holding in the district?
I'm a councillor in the district council.
Okay, tell us what happened.
Without any portfolio. Yeah, I have an independent mind about this motion, Honourable Speaker. And the issue here, Honourable Members, is whether citizens matter anymore in elections or it is just sugar, money and soap. I think that is the issue at hand. Not only in Rakai, but everywhere in this country. Reason being, Madam Speaker, I will tag all the question on the way the Electoral Commission is carrying on its business. Are the citizens of this country sensitized of their rights and responsibilities? Are they aware why they are supposed to vote? Who to vote?
So you are putting the blame on the Electoral Commission?
Yes, because people don't know. For them, they think, once I'm poor, I must elect that one. Who gives me money? Whoever comes with the soap, money or sugar, that is the person I must elect. And in the end, we end up suffering.
I've not heard anywhere on radio or on TV where the Electoral Commission is telling us to vote by money, but they're advocating for us to vote, go register and vote responsibly. Thank you so much.
It appears as if you are stamping in what I'm saying. Just because Electoral Commission just comes in to tell people, go and register, go and vote. You have to, those people above 18 and above, you are now free to vote. But they don't actually go beyond that to tell us, why should we vote?
I think the Electoral Commission you've had, you are not facilitating this nation with civic education. It is high time you do that, because we are just moving close to 2016 general elections. What is the situation on the ground, sir?
First of all, it's vital, it's democratic, that people, the grassroots people, to be deeply involved in elections. It exercises democracy. And some time back, about 1 year, they proposed that this current government, the parliament was proposing to extend the Kisanja, the years, such that they prepare themselves. Personally, I was opposed to that, because it could not indicate the features of democracy in the country. But this depends the way the grassroots people, the people in the area, are sensitized, for instance. Take an example of myself. I'm a councillor representing Kakuto sub-county. In actual sense. But for the years, almost 15 years as of now, the people of Kakuto vote me unopposed, representing them to the council. It depends the way I talk to them, I sensitize them. For instance, a councillor is paid only 100,000. More or less, these are just peanuts. It's more or less voluntary services. I tell them, please, I don't have soap, I don't have money to pay. But I'm gonna deliver services to you. And indeed, people of my sub-county, Kakuto sub-county, they have achieved a lot. Please, you don't have money. Don't give people money. Don't sell your house, don't sell your vehicle, because you want to go to parliament.
So yeah, that is good. If leaders come out, leaders like the Secretary General of the NRM comes out and tells people there is no vote, that would be good. But if they lead, it's unfortunate. Please, the lady here, can you take up the podium?
Thank you very
much. My counterpart, I will give you another opportunity.
Thank you.
They don't ask for money, but supposing that now it is already, it is right a season. Somebody is an incumbent, would like to do what, would like to go back. But when you go back and tell those people, and they start gauging that there is nothing is done during your term, of course they will start looking for money. The chairperson has given us an example that for him, he did not ask, nobody asked him money, neither soap or anything. Everything rotates on service delivery. If you dish out money, these people go and do nothing in parliament or anywhere. They just need to compensate their own funds. And then the next elections.
Some of them sell their houses, they sell their land.
Yes, the next elections, the voters will see that there is nothing done to us, no roads, no drugs in the health centers. They will automatically wait for a soda or man. But if service delivery is done to the people, you will find that the voters will only start gauging that there is some so and so has done something for us.
Let's vote for him. They ask for money from
they
you.
They ask money for.
So it is a matter of it is a matter of you political leaders and the voters to decide on which way to go. Yes. Should we be given money? Should we also give money? Or we should serve the public? Let's go for a short break. And when we come back, we are going to go deep into what happens in elections. Welcome back. You are still watching NTV People's Parliament sitting here in Rakai District in the county of Chotera, discussing issues of election. Do people matter anymore in elections, or it's about money, sugar, and everything, whatever you may take, whatever you may give? Yes, honorable member, you hold the podium.
Yes, please. Thank you, honorable speaker. My name is Mbetejeze Godfrey, Deputy RDC Rakai. In my opinion, when I look at this discussion concept, to me, I think people matter in determining election process. Why do I say this? Because I have seen situations in Uganda and even in Rakai where people dish out money and people determine the winner. The problem we have is sentimental perception amongst the population, especially the biggest leaders. For them, they think that they can win votes out of giving money. But we know some leaders are charismatic leaders. People know that they can deliver. Whether they give money or not, they can be voted into power. The speaker has given us some...
But when these people receive these goodies, when they receive the money from the people who are campaigning, do they realize that they are losing their right to bring leaders to account?
You know, it's not their fault. For the people, it's not their fault that they receive. They receive or deny.
Whose fault is it?
The fault is for the elite who give out.
Why do they receive? Why don't they say no? We are not ready to be bribed.
You know, human beings by nature.
Yes.
I thank you, Madam Speaker. I would like to inform the pre-country speaker that the issue here is not about electing, because people might elect someone who has not given them any money, but still that electing someone who has not given them money, that also is an indicator that the other one who is being voted out of office was not delivering. You coming into power without giving people money does not necessarily mean that you are going to deliver.
That you are the best.
Yeah, you are the
it's
best.
It's about service delivery.
Okay. Of like,
thank you. Go ahead and wind up.
So the perception of the public and the leaders, I think the leaders are the ones who should show the way to the people they are going to lead. If the I think in my opinion, if we shall have good leaders, there should be people to put a benchmark of what they want their nation or their people to behave.
But the people, let me hear from the voters. You people are here when somebody comes up and does not give you anything. You say, "Katumutulese mutya, how have you left us?"
Mine is about telling the people who want to be voted to know that when we are voting them into office, they go without nothing. 1 year, he comes up to driving a Range Rover. He builds a new house. Then we, the voters, know these people get money. So when they
come to us, money from them.
Yes, when they come to us, then it comes to a man's decision, one man's decision, to say, why am I benefiting? Yes, I see a road, I see water, boreholes are there, but this person is going to go to office and benefit, and his family is going to be rich.
So what you do, you ask money
yes,
from
him? Yes, I say, give me something, you know.
Is that true, honorable members?
Yes.
That is unfortunate. It's unfortunate. Yes, ma'am. What do you have to say about this?
My name is Rosinal Boa. I'm a retired senior civil citizen of this district. I've been a senior education officer for the last 14 years. There are so many issues concerning the way our voters do behave.
What are those issues?
First of all, as one participant mentioned, there is lack of civic education. I've got a chance of moving around the whole constituents in Rakai, in Kaputo, where I've conducted meetings on every village. But it's appalling. The situation is appalling. We are blaming so many people, but all of us here stand to be blamed, especially the leaders, right from the chairperson LC1 up to the top. Not only the electoral commission, what have we done? We all come to the offices for and on the mandate of those people to represent them, to effectively deliver
services
to them. So
we should not give pointing fingers to you.
Definitely.
But
we should not give a point.
It's my responsibility.
It's your responsibility. People are crying for some even trivial, very, very trivial things are not explained to them. I went to those people and asked them, have you ever seen any coin coming from government? They are saying, no, we have not got anything from the president, nothing from the government. They don't know anything that comes from the government. When they're walking on a tarmac road, when they have
There is no civic education. Yes, what do you have to say about that? I'll give you another opportunity.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I'm Rugema Lawrence Salongo, Kakuto People's Parliament, as well as Sanje People's Parliament Speaker. I don't know who brought that slogan. People in the community say, no money, no vote.
Is that the slogan in Rakai?
Yes.
No money, no vote?
Yes. Reason being, these politicians took politics as a business.
Who introduced that slogan?
I don't know. But it is there. So when you go there asking for the votes, you be ready to pay something. If you don't, no vote.
So when I give you my money, do you have the right to demand for me to go and lobby for a road, lobby for water?
Yes.
Don't you think you have lost
but
that right?
But some leaders do not do so. After getting that post, they just go and wait for the other season of elections.
Because they have paid their money to be voted.
Yes, they have paid.
I would like to
inform. Move closer to the microphone, please.
I would like to inform the precedent speaker that the reasons why the local people use the slogan that no money, no vote it is the problem of the politicians. How? These are the people who come to the local people and deceive them that they are going to do for them such and such things.
They promise roads.
They come with empty promises.
Schools, hospitals.
Good. Mm-hmm. Then at the end of the day, when the local people give out their votes and the person goes, this is the person who will become dormant. He will become like a dormant volcano. So whereby the person
supporting me.
Whereby the person will react. Whereby the person will react when is targeting
comes back.
When is targeting for the second term. So people also they have learned whom politicians are. So before
they
out
come
their
back,
vote,
they say if you don't bring money, they don't vote you back.
Yes.
Thank you, please
thank
wind
you,
up.
Yeah. As I'm winding up, the constitution says power belongs to the people. but not to all.
Thank you for that. Yes, you have the podium.
I dignify you, Madam Chair. I'm Sebu Majon, a local person, an ordinary person, citizen from Kakuto. I strongly support this motion here, whereby he has given a slogan which says, no money, no vote. And that slogan will stay.
Why?
In Kakuto here, rather in Rakai.
Do you people support the no money, no slogan, no, no, no vote slogan?
No.
These people whom we elect, we send them to offices, knowing that these are the people who are going to come back and deliver the services.
Talk to the people, please.
These are the people whom we think we send them to those big offices, knowing that they are coming back to deliver services to us. But when they go there, they also have their own slogan there when they reach there, that for God and my stomach and my family. So if we do send them there to cater for their stomachs, then they don't mind about this ordinary person down here. Why not me asking them for leather money from them? Still, these people whom we send there again, we go to hospitals. There is no treatment in hospitals, whereby a doctor just writes for you, there are no drugs there, go and buy in a clinic. Then do really elections matter to an ordinary man like me? There are plots now like in Mtukula. The chairperson has gone out. He would have bear witness to me. The speaker's around. There are plots in Mtukula. We, the local people down there, we don't know the processes where we pass to ask for those plots. But you find that it is only those big people in offices that are the people that have benefited in those plots.
Okay.
Then, from that extent, can you say that elections matter to people like us here?
Okay, thank you.
Honorable Speaker.
Yes.
Members of People's Parliament, I'm Juliet Subchinyamatama, and I'm here to oppose the motion that it's no longer sugar, salt, and money in Rakai District.
But that's what the people are saying.
With evidence that the Chotera County MP is an independent candidate who was not an incumbent, that weighs him on cash to people. The other evidence is the chairperson is also an independent who was not an incumbent. So in Rakai District, it has changed. It is no longer money, salt, and sugar. People are now educated. People have been sensitized about their rights. So people know why they should vote. Another evidence is in Kochi County. It is one sanja, one term, deliver. If you don't deliver, they don't push you back, whether you come with your money or not. So I am so proud to mention that Rakai District is going to be among the districts in Uganda that are that have led a revolution. Rakai District, we have led a revolution of sugar, salt, for voters. We know our rights. And this has been done by different leaders of the district.
Thank you.
Youth.
Thank you
so much.
Honorable member. I think you have heard, honorable members. It's better you get rid of this slogan of no money, no vote. Yes, you have the podium.
Thank you, madam. I'm Zimaze Charles Mwau, a retired civil servant, and currently chairman of District Service Commission. Now, the whole issue of no money, no vote has existed in Uganda, and indeed it still exists in some areas.
Who do you think is to blame, Muzee?
Yes, who is to blame? To blame is the government for the following reasons. As we speak now, there is a poor distribution of the national cake.
Yes.
Can you imagine, recently I heard that members of parliament are going to have a pay raise of 40%. Can you imagine that a director of a certain authority gets 45 million shillings per month? Can you imagine that members of the public service swindled 169 billion shillings and the court acquitted them? That means we people who are at the grassroots are unhappy with the way government is handling government affairs.
So
the distribution of the distribution of the national cash is so poor, and somebody said there should be, for instance, a salary commission. How can one civil servant obtain 45 million shillings a month and another one gets 300,000 shillings. So these are some of the issues. When you come around, you are looking for the vote. People would say, yes, we know you are going to earn. But before you go, you
give us money.
And Madam Speaker,
And must the RDC want to give you information?
Information is in a question form. Who is the government? Government has three arms, you know. And who are the policymakers? And who determines the policymakers? It's you, the citizenry.
He's asking you a question, so, actually. He's not giving
so
information.
So I think it's incumbent upon us all to know that, in fact, for your information, the problem we have in the country is the lack of patriotism and mindset. Actually, in quotes, ignorance. I may be a master's, I may be a doctor, but I may be ignorant. That's the problem we have. African countries, Uganda inclusive, the problem we have is ours.
Yes. Okay, thank you.
The gentleman is talking about patriotism. Can you teach me to love my mother? You cannot. Ugandans are not patriotic because income is poorly distributed. That's one. Secondly, Ugandans are not patriotic because of poor obtained chances of getting employment, and that's the role of government. The other issue is about corruption. So people come to look for a vote, and people know that these people are going to eat to make their stomachs swell. So before you go, you give us option.
Thank you.
Yes. So in summary, why people are asking for money, it is because the national cash is badly distributed. Secondly, there is a poor service delivery, and lastly, government has not put any effort to ensure that the youth and the women are properly employed.
Thank you, Honourable Member. I think you have heard the people of Rakai are speaking. They are really speaking very passionately about why they are asking money for you leaders who come for elective positions. It is high time you performed. It is high time you delivered such that these people do not ask for money from you. Let's go for a short break. And when we come back, we are going to look at what it takes to move out, to move money out of politics. Welcome back. You are still watching NTV People's Parliament seated here in Rakai District, the county of Chotera, discussing a very important topic. Do local people matter anymore in politics, or it's about money, sugar, and the like? What do you think the people of Ntungamo, the people of Amuria, the people of Guru, what do you think? Yes. What can we do to remove money from politics as we approach 2016?
Thank you, Honorable Speaker. My name is Charles Njuba Nsimbe. I'm a district councillor and the secretary for production and natural resources. Personally, I'm not going to erase anything related to money into politics, because the major problem is initially made. If we are all members of Uganda and we have a contribution to our nation, the problem was one, Honorable Speaker. We are exercising democracy at all levels, and we are letting people of their levels of illiteracy to elect members of parliament who are actually having key issues to do with the whole nation that will build the entire nation. This is my view. If we are really practicing democracy at levels of villages, it would start there. And then we get to know what specific group of people is supposed to elect, and what kind of leadership are they supposed to stop. Then we go to another level of district, and say what class of people are supposed to elect leaders that are going to the district. Then from there we would have another level of people that is going to elect the members of parliament. That is the class of people that is actually going to know that we are supposed to elect so and so for such and such
says
issues.
The power belongs to all the people of Uganda. So how are you going to make people into classes?
Yeah, power belongs to all people of Uganda. But which people are we using to decide upon what
there
issues?
There are Ugandans who own this country.
It is right, but I'm saying
If it is out of adult,
somebody wants to give you
okay,
information.
Okay, fine.
Take up the other microphone, please.
Thank you so much, Madam Speaker. One of the things that is bringing sugar salt is because we tend to underlook our voters and think they are in classes. So if we are delivering service delivery goes to all Ugandans at all levels that we think they are levels. So there is no level that should be put in erecting a leader.
People think, Honorable Speaker, that the member parliament has gone for business. And even those who are coming for posts today feel, I've got some good money, I would come to be a member parliament.
Okay, thank you.
Be anybody
you are entitled to your opinion, sir.
I'm by the name of King Tukisekulo Patrick, Council C5 and aspiring C5 Chairman, Rakai District. Mr. Speaker, Madam Speaker, mine goes to the electorate. As one of the current speakers said, the problem is we, the people who go in to be voted. Because, for example, if I'm contesting with a big man, we contest with people in offices. And if they have not delivered the service, the only issue that can bring them back to office is by giving out Chintu Kidogo to these people. And as I told you last time, many people know that you went in the office without even having a tie. Now you are putting on a very nice tie, a very nice suit. So everybody is looking
at
you.
Which is not bad, because
you're
earning.
So people know you are earning. Then another thing is above.
So, Honourable Member, do you want the MP you have elected as a teacher to remain walking on foot?
No.
To remain riding a bicycle?
When you look at the electorate,
speak to the people, please.
Excuse me. When you look at the electorate, the current speaker said, talked about salary. We can hear I'm earning only 100,000 from government. I'm a councillor C5. Another person is getting 25 million. And on top of that, is given a vehicle over 140 million shillings. Then that person, when you look at that difference between that person earning 25 million shillings.
Somebody wants to give information. Young man, come and take this podium.
I thought the information is given to me. So who allows that information? You know
it is
me?
The speaker.
Okay.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Now, here, we have a problem, which is one, people's mindset. Aziz has been talking about that. People forgot their mindset changed upside down from service to money. Aziz has been talking about that. People think whomever is elected goes to eat money. That's why they come out to say, let me first benefit before he goes in. That's why people say, that one has eaten enough. Let us send another to eat. So we want, it's high time here in Rakai that we unlocked
of that mindset. Thank you. Sir, you are aspiring.
I want to wind up.
So you are when the speaker is speaking, you keep quiet.
Okay,
you are aspiring to become the chairperson of the district.
Exactly.
There is a car for you. There is allowances for you.
Yes.
Are you going to leave those things?
Those ones,
entitlement to that office.
Yes, but those are entitlement because it is the government which buys them to give the chairman.
Likewise, the
end. This one,
likewise, are you not aware?
One,
likewise,
I'm aware.
Can you listen?
The electorate know.
Can you listen when the speaker is speaking?
Mm.
Are you not aware that the cars that MPs are getting, the salaries that they're earning, are their entitlement as members of parliament?
Exactly, but in that salary, they get a salary, and then there is also that. Handing over vehicle. But last, I want to wind up.
Just a moment, and this young lady wants to give
information,
you
information again.
Yes.
Thank you so much, Madam Speaker. This is one challenge that we have. Leaders themselves confuse the public and the voters by telling them, look, he's driving a good car, don't vote him next time. So instead of focusing on what helps Ugandans as service delivery, we are just setting our minds to benefits and profits. So one problem that we have is one, sensitization on on voting rights, what it means. So
which information are you giving to them?
So the information, information is not about people driving good cars, they are entitled to that, but let's focus on service delivery.
But
thank
before
you.
That, she was telling me that the voters don't know. They cannot even see that this person is driving a good vehicle, but she's contesting. These people know that this is a Mercedes-Benz which buys so and such price.
So these voters know. But lastly, there is what we call above. Now today, we are going to a period of elections. The above will come and say, support so and so. When you talk about that, when you talk about above, everybody knows above comes with a bag of money. So they are waiting to receive that money because you are putting somebody they don't know, they don't like, they never had. But because you want him to go through all of her, you must give them money. Then they say, okay, let her go, let him go.
What can we do? Yes, in 2 minutes. Take up this one. Use this podium, please. What do you think should be done to take money out of politics? If I don't give you an opportunity, you don't just take on the podium, please. Go ahead. Yes, go and sit. I'll give you an opportunity.
Okay, Madam Speaker, I think what we need to do as a country, first of all, the issue of civic education, there has been lack of coordination. And we don't know currently who is in charge of civic education because Uganda Human Rights Commission, which is constitutionally mandated to do that role, has for many years not done its role. And there is also conflicting information about who is to do that, because there are many government bodies who are supposed to do that. If the Electoral Commission does voter education, and that confusion needs to be also removed from the populace. Secondly, what we need to do as a country is political party financing. For a long time, political parties in this country have not been funded. So what happens is the individuals who have money, are the ones who go on canvassing for support from the electorate, and then they continue giving these things. Thirdly, what we need to do is to make sure that voter bribery is criminalized in this country, and to a great extent. Those who give bribes, those who give sugar and soap, the law should move in to touch on them. But currently what we see is that everybody is doing it. Finally, Madam Speaker, what we need to do in this country is to eradicate poverty. Because people who are poor are not going to refuse the soap and sugar which we are talking about. So as long as this country, majority of the people still live under the poverty line, we are not going to eradicate sugar and the money in the elections. Okay. So I move to...
Thank you. In 1 minute, the chairman of the district, what do you have to say?
We appeal to the government to extend industries, to extend industries in far places from Kampala.
Like Chotera.
So that we can, these industries can accommodate and employ the biggest number of our people. Because if you see how the rate of bribery in urban centers is not as the same as bribery in the rural settings.
Okay.
So with that, we can move ahead. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you. Lady, please, in 1 minute also.
Decentralization is almost dying. It was a revolutionary approach to service delivery. Decision making does not come right from down. The financing of districts has completely gone down, yet we're supposed to be getting taxes right from the districts were supposed, by the time decentralization was put in place, districts were supposed to collect taxes, okay, which taxes are no longer collected.
Okay.
We are talking about civic education, who should do it. People cannot go down around the districts without anything. They need facilitation. So there is a lot that needs to be done. Let decentralization be put back to its levels as it was supposed to do.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Honourable Member. Those who are responsible for civic education, the candidates who are seeking elective positions, the voters there, the government as advocate for the votability. What about the people? Do they understand their right? Do they know why they are voting these people to these elective positions? Let's do civic education and money will go out of politics. I am still Agnes Nandutu, the Speaker of People's Parliament. And until next time, I adjourn this house.